What is up, legends? Martin Legend, Theodore the Magic Mascot, and my lovely wife back with another video. Today's video I've done to a couple of people, actual magicians, and they have absolutely no idea how I did it. Okay, so this one, you will fool absolutely everybody, so if you wouldn't mind dropping a subscribe, it took me, you guys can't really see there, I don't think, like this you can see, it took me a very, very long time to make this. Anyway guys, but you'll see it in a little while. It took me a very long time to make this, and it's just an amazing trick. If you wouldn't mind subscribing and post notifications on. Memberships have been updated because people say that $39.90 is a little bit much. They want to support me, so I created another level. The $39.99 membership is still the same. Now there's a Junior Legend one where you get one extra video a month, and you also still get the loyalty badges in the comments to flex on everybody that you're a member of. The best YouTube channel ever. And the only YouTube channel to feature a magic dinosaur, I'm pretty sure. I don't think Barney is a YouTube channel, I hope not. But he's not magical. Theodore's
magical.
He's magical. No, he's not magical.
He's a different kind of magic.
He's tall, he can sing and dance, he's purple and yellow. For those of you who's
green.
A little bit older, purple, green and yellow. For those of you that's
not
a little bit older, he's basically Dennis Rodman. Google Dennis Rodman, Barney's. He's 6'8", he can dance, he can sing, and he's purple and
green.
He's Dennis Rodman. Just Google Dennis Rodman.
It's Dennis Rodman. It's Dennis purple Rodman. And green.
He dyed his hair usually purple and green. And he was a basketball player. And yes, he was 6'8". So Barney's basically Dennis Rodman. But anyway, I digress. There's now a $9.99 membership where you get one extra video a month and you still get the loyalty badges. If you guys wouldn't mind, if you want to support me, it's $9.99 a month. It's not even a dollar for my US friends. But apart from that, that was me going off on a complete tangent, but I enjoy that. Let's get straight into today's trick. Okay, so I've got this in plain sight that you can see it never goes away. I'm just going to quickly show you that there's no setup to the deck, right? You can see no setup to the deck. You happy? Okay, Theodore's happy. Okay, so I'm going to have you make two selections of cards. So I'm going to deal the top two cards like this and like this. And we're going to make them 10 by adding up. Do you understand?
Yep.
Okay, so I'm going to go from 8 and then it's 9, 10. And then I'm going to go from 7, 8, 9, 10. You still with me?
Yep.
So now 8 plus 7 is 15. The 15th card from the top is yours. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. The 15th card is yours. I'm just going to place it here because I don't want you to see the card yet. So that's card number one. I'm just going to place the rest of the cards here. Now we're going to select a second card. Theodore, just tell me stop.
Stop.
Okay, so that's your card. I'm just going to place, that's your second card. I'm going to place that there. So now we're done with the deck of cards for now. So now what I want you to do is I'm just going to grab a piece of pen and paper quickly. Okay, so I'm going to turn my head, and what I want you to do is I want you to pick any two-digit number and write it down for everybody at home to see as well. Can you just confirm I have my head turned?
He's got his head turned.
Okay, so pick any two-digit number.
Theodore is watching him. He will attack if he turns his head back. What number can I take?
Any two-digit number, like 45, 52, 19, 21.
Can I take my number?
Okay, so I would pick 23 because 23 is one of my favorite numbers because of numerology, and this is a numerology trick. So what I would do is I would ask you, or I'm asking you, to add your two digits together. Like I would pick 23, I would add in 2 plus 3 equals 5.
Okay, got it.
Okay, so now you take a new number and you deduct it from your original number. So I had 23 and then my new number was 5, so I would deduct 5 from 23 and that would be 18.
Okay, I got my new number.
Okay, so you got your new number. Okay. So, I can turn around now because I can't influence your number again. Okay, so your number is 9. So you picked 13. You like 13. Okay, it got to 4. 4 deducted from 13 is 9. So 9 is your number. Okay, I made this list earlier of every single number from 1 through to 99. Every single one you could possibly get. Now, we got to your number. Let me just keep these cards in plain view. Your number, which is 9. I'm just going to move this closer to the camera. Your number, which is...
The ace and the king.
9. But even more, the first card was this one, right?
Yeah.
It's because ace could be first and a king could be second, or a king could be first and ace could be second. Your first card, an ace. And your second card, a king. And you can see they are all completely. So, guys, if you want to learn how to do this, stick around for the tutorial.
That is impressive.
Okay, guys, so you can force the two selections any way you want. What I did was I made the ace the 22nd card and the king the 23rd card. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. And then the 22nd card, I made the ace. So that's my first force. And the second card is the king, the 23rd card. So those are my two forces. You pick any cards you want. I just chose an ace and a king. So now you would force the 22nd card by doing exactly what I did. You place down the first two cards and you would make them, let's just use different numbers, like a 3 and a 9, that's a little bit better. And you would count them up to 10, 7, or 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 9, 10. These two together would then be, with all of this, the 22nd card, so this is 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Their first selection, which is the ace. That's how you force the 22nd card on them. Easy as that. Now, the next card is the king. So you just place all these cards at the bottom of the deck with the king at the top. So now I forced the king on them, or the ace on them. Now I just did a riffle force where I said, tell me when to stop. And I slide out all the cards except the king. And then I force the king on them. I'll show you again how to do it. So you riffle down the side of the deck, say stop, stop there, okay. I force the king on you, that's your second card, but you don't want them looking at these cards just yet. Just remember that's the first card, that's the second card. Now from here on you need to create something like this, all the way from 1 through 99. And you want all the multiple, you can write down anything you want, any two cards you want, but all the multiples of 9, you write an ace and a king. 9, as you guys know, is an ace and a king. Then the next multiple is 18, is an ace and a king, but it's so jumbled up they will never notice that. Then the next one is 27, which is an ace and a king. The next one is 36, which is an ace and a king. 45, 54, and so on and so forth. Every multiple of 9 is an ace and a king. The rest is completely irrelevant. You make it up as you go. So 9, 18, 27, 36, 45, 54, 63, 72, 81, 90, and 99. No matter which two-digit number they will select, if they do this correct and they deduct it correctly, they will always end up on a multiple of 9. Let's take a random number. 45. Okay, 45 is 4 plus 5, which is 9. 9 deducted from 45 is 36. Let's take 22. 22 is 2 plus 2 is 4. 4 from 22 is 18, which is a multiple of 9. So no matter how you do it, it will always add up as a multiple of 9. Hers just happened to be the first multiple of 9. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this one. This is one that I really enjoy doing for you. Until next time, Martin Legend, peace.